Shalom, this is Rabbi David Eidenson, author of the book Secret of the Scale on Human Relations. Our website is secretscale.com. We have many videos there on timely Torah topics. Today, we want to discuss shame. Shame is a trait which in Torah is very crucial. A person who has shame, has busha, in Hebrew the word is busha, will not sin quickly because he's ashamed to do the wrong thing. We don't mean shame that a person has shame about himself. We don't mean that a person who does bad things, who has failed, has to be ashamed. That we don't mean. We mean shame at doing the wrong thing. We do not mean shame that is negative and deleterious to the person's function. So actually, the level of shame that we have, positive or negative, is a major motor in our lives. If we have a positive shame and we are gauging ourselves with our values and we are ashamed to do the wrong thing, shame is a positive thing and elevates us and brings us to do what we want to do. If, on the other hand, we become ashamed of ourselves in a negative way and we say, oh, I failed, I did a bad thing, I hurt somebody, I hurt myself, I'm a nothing. We get into that, that's a negative shame. And this shame destroys us. The first shame, the shame of doing something wrong, elevates us, and so we are so happy with ourselves because we're ashamed of doing wrong and we're in the environment of goodness and happiness. The negative shame pulls us down into sadness, pulls us down into negative, self-defeating thoughts. And this level of being sad is a major obstacle to spirituality and all achievements. We have here a passage in the book Yechezkel. The prophet Yechezkel, Ezekiel, spoke to the Jewish people between the first temple's destruction and 70 years later, the second temple's being built. He spoke to the Jewish people at this time, and the Jewish people then, they were in the mood to be ashamed. They realized that the prophets had warned them if they didn't repent, the temple would be destroyed. They would be exiled from their land. And now the prophet addresses them, okay, you failed. The temple was destroyed. A lot of people were killed. Many people were dragged away from their homes or brought to Babylonia to be slaves, to be wanderers. And God had mercy on the Jews that they flourished somehow in the 70 years of exile because great rabbis were recognized by the kings and elevated to high positions. But still the Jews were foreigners in a strange land, and they had plenty of time to think about what they had done wrong. They had worshipped idols, they had done other sins, and they were ashamed of it. And now was the time to talk about penitence. But here, in the book of Ezekiel, Yechezkel, it tells us a new idea about shame, a new different idea about shame, and he wants the Jewish people to understand where they stand. They stand in the exile and there is no temple. If there is no temple, there is no place in the world consecrated and dedicated to the presence of God, because in the temple period, anybody, Solomon prayed that the Gentile, any Gentile could come. Not just a Jew, but any Gentile could come to this temple and speak directly to God, and God's presence was there. And whatever the Gentile asked for, he was given. The Jews were not given this. The Jews were not rewarded with this level because the Jews were sometimes refused. But if a Gentile came, the Gentile was always rewarded with his request. This was the temple, and when the nations of the world saw the greatness of the temple, they greatly respected the Jewish people. And yet the Jews had this wonderful temple and everything was going nicely. and they had to sin with idolatry and other sins that they did until the temple was destroyed. And of course, the Jewish people now sitting in exile, in the 70-year exile about 2,500 years ago in Babylonia and Persia or wherever they were scattered, they were ashamed of what they had done. But now the prophet Yechezkel tells us a new level about shame. He says, you know what I'm going to do? He says, I'm going to describe for you what the temple looks like. There's going to be a new temple. In fact, there's going to be a new temple that will be destroyed, and then there's going to be a future temple that will not be destroyed. He says, let's look at this temple. This is what it looks like. These are the measurements, and this is this, this is that. And he said, and be ashamed that because of your sins, there is no temple. This is a new level of shame. And you, son of man, God says to him, tell the house of Israel about the house and let them be ashamed of their sins. And then let them measure the building and its various properties. What does this mean? Let them be ashamed of their sins and let them measure. We have to measure the damage that we did with our sins. The prophet Yechezkel, the prophet Ezekiel, told the Jewish people, be ashamed. Because of your sins, there is no temple. And let's talk about the temple. Not just that it's a nice building, but the power of the temple was to bring God's presence to earth so that everybody knows there's a God. Everybody knows there's a God. Why were the Jews honored? How did the Jews survive the 70 years of exile? Usually a nation that lives in a country and a huge army comes in like the Babylonian army with the mighty king Nebuchadnezzar and he destroys the country and plows it up and destroys it and burns its temple and drives people away, the ones that he didn't kill. Usually people like that disappear from the face of the earth as a nation. They have no physical country and they're just scattered and they're helpless, and they just disappear. But the Jewish people did not disappear. They came back, and one of the reasons was because the kings themselves saw the hand of God. The kings themselves saw that the Jews have very holy rabbis, such as the prophet Daniel, such as Mordechai, who was also a prophet, and the kings, the Babylonian kings, and the Persian kings respected the rabbis, gave them prominent positions in the government, and allowed the Jews to continue. And eventually the Persian kings helped the Jews return to Israel and helped support them to rebuild the second temple. So therefore, God is always with us. There's always a God, even in the exile. Imoi anochi b'tzara. God says, I am with you in pain and suffering. God is with us in exile. God has great pain. And God cries out and he says, woe to a father that the children are not here to sit at the table with him. The father, God is the father of the Jewish people. He sees them scattered and suffering in exile. And God cries. And from this also we have to be ashamed. And we have to be ashamed that God's pain that the Jewish people are not in Israel with a built-up temple, with a functioning temple. And the prophet Yechezkel is telling us, let us be ashamed of this temple that is not being built because of our sins.